Hi guys, Reaper here. Welcome back to another one of my videos. Thanks for tuning in. Today I'm going to talk to you about the Tier 8 Caldari State storyline mission, Mega Corporation. Mega Corporation can be unlocked by clicking on encounters and checking out the storyline mission. Over here we see Mega Corporation. So if we scroll down, we can see there's a number of missions required. The diamond-shaped icons represents a standard mission, which will be around 700,000 ISK and fairly easy to complete. And then the more rare mission, the kidnapping one at the bottom with a circular icon, that's a more difficult mission, which is usually ranging between 2.5 million ISK and 5 million ISK. Once you've got all of these, you will unlock the mission and you will be able to click and accept it from this location. When you do so, that will appear in as a book in your cargo container, in a ship in space, and if you dock in station, you're able to accept that mission, therefore sending it here into your journal. This mission is comprised of several parts. We have a lot of traveling here at the beginning. We talk to somebody, we dock at a first station, we collect some cargo, and then we travel some jumps and we drop off the cargo. Then we talk to somebody else, and then we're at the part I'm at right now, which is to travel three jumps and annihilate all enemies at the mission beacon. So this is just one set of enemies that we need to, or NPCs that we need to take out, consisting of four waves, which I'll discuss with you in a moment. And then we just have to talk to somebody else, travel a few jumps and scan a system in general, talk to somebody, and then we'll receive the 30 million ISK reward advertised over here, and we'll be awarded a soldier supply chest, which will appear in a station randomly in space. The best way to find where that is to go into your inventory, like so, and then click on your personal assets at the bottom. Then you're able to see all of your stations. If you've noticed, a station has popped up here, which wasn't there before. That's likely to be the location of the cargo container. You could then travel to that location and receive your reward. Okay guys, let's have a look at some of the NPCs, rats that we're going to have in space. There's four waves in total with quite a number of ships, so you're going to need to put a fair bit of time aside for this. Obviously, the better the ship, the faster you're going to do it. Wave one, we have six ships. Wave 2, we have 7 ships. Wave 3, we have 11 ships plus 4 elites. And wave 4, we have 16 ships plus 6 elites. So you're going to want to be careful in the last two waves. Okay, looking at this, we're going to warp in now, and I'm going to take the beginning wave or the first wave at zero, as I'm not too worried with six regular ships. I should be able to tank that just fine. So here we go with the first wave. I'm going to lock down the smaller ships first, and if you're in a less competent ship, as I mentioned in one of my previous videos, you would want to warp in at different ranges depending on how well you can tank. Okay, so we're taking these guys down pretty quickly. For the benefit of explaining, I have got the video sped up two times just so that this doesn't drag on for too long, as it does take a while on the final waves with the number of battle cruisers you've got to chew through. So wave one here is going down pretty quickly. As you can see, my cap's pretty stable. I'm able to tank these guys very easy, not causing too much trouble. Okay, just getting this Blackbird down now. As you can see, my DPS is 718, running hot. I've got this Gistam C-type shield booster, which is boosting a lovely 600 shield every 5 seconds, which is enabling me to tank this quite easily. However, when I get to the last two waves, I will be a bit more cautious due to the elite ships. Okay, so this last guy now is starting to go down. Okay, moving on to the second wave number two. Here we've got
a few more ships. Again, I'm going to get in nice and close as I'm not going to have any trouble tanking this. So I've got my automatic orbit set and engaged at 8 kilometers, which is the optimal of my Nosferatu. And I'm focusing on some of the bigger ships to start with. There's no frigates on this wave that I can see, and I'm not being webbed, so pretty much I can pick and choose who I'm going to take out first. Usually best to take out the closest in this scenario. My capacitor is nice and stable at the moment, and I'm not having to boost continuously. However, it doesn't hurt to leave your shield booster on if you're maintaining a steady cap using your Nosferatu. Okay, coming towards the end of this wave now, what I'm going to do is a pretty standard tactic, which is to slow down on the last target, and then I'd want to kind of check my range, how far I am from the beacon. I'm quite an okay distance at the moment, however I'd prefer to be a bit further away, as the NPCs can, or the rats can, spawn either side of the beacon by 10 maybe 15 kilometers, and I don't want them all to spawn on me. So I've stopped my damage for a second whilst I burn away from this guy, getting more distance from the as you can see there, 33 kilometers. So going to go a bit further. Turn off your auto orbit at this point, because it's very dangerous to auto orbit with a massive wave with some elite ships. Now I'm going to take out this guy, and here we go with the final wave number 3. Now on this wave there's an elite Naga, which is going to come into view pretty soon. There he is. This elite Naga does maybe 3 to 4 kilometers per second. As you can see, he is, for a battle cruiser, moving incredibly fast. He's going to overshoot me now. I'm applying whatever damage I can, but if you're aligned and burning away, you're not going to be webbed. And I can assure you now, this Naga that shoots missile-sized battleship-sized weapons is not going to do any damage to you whatsoever. He is just going to be a pain and be difficult to kill. For that reason, I'm going to stay away from the pact and enable myself enough time to whittle this guy down. He is going to loop in and outside of range. I'm going to have to approach him somewhat and then burn away again. As long as I'm keeping my distance from all of these other ships with a combined high amount of DPS, I should be fine. So this Naga's now about to go into shield, armor damage, and on his armor he's a lot weaker. But again, he can pull back a huge amount of shield. He's still traveling at a tremendous speed within range. Yep, he's just pulled back 3/4 of his shield in one go. Which I wish I had a shield booster that powerful. Okay. Gonna get this guy down now. He's very low. And then we can focus on the rest of the pact. Okay, so I've taken him out. There is still the entire mob remaining, but as you can see, because I've been traveling away, they are now fairly separated due to the fact that they're far apart from each other. I can go in now at a closer range and get some Nosferatus on this elite mower, take him down fairly quickly, and then I'll move on to the next closest target, rinse and repeat until we get through the entire group here. And then just remember, when you've got the last ship targeted, you need to make sure you have a very large distance from the beacon, because that last wave has a lot of damage. Okay, I'm just getting back in range again now. I'm gonna start applying some more damage. Swap weapons to this guy. He's an elite Ferox. Going down pretty quickly. Quite good DPS when I've got my weapon damage mod running in the low slot there. The ballistic control gets me up to over 700 DPS, which is a major help. And at the moment I've got my orbit set again at the 8 kilometer, and I'm using some manual piloting here. I don't want to keep my auto orbit on all the time. Okay, starting to chew through these guys now. Just 5 ships left. Also, when you're reaching the end of a particular wave, try to get your capacitor as high as possible, as at the start of the next wave, you're going to be trying to keep distance, not using the Nosferatu, trying to shield boost a bit and take out and pick out what targets you can. So, last few guys here. I'm expecting that on the final wave, I'm going to have to do perhaps a warp out to station, depending on how many elites. We've got 6 elites there, depends how many are all micro warp driving on top of me at the same time. Again, you can have a super tank and be incredibly good, but all the same, if you've got a lot of ships on top of you at the same time, it's not worth the risk. Better to be safe. So now I've got this last guy here. I'm going to want to assess how far I am from the beacon. As you can see, I'm a quite a good distance there, and so therefore I've manually decided to pilot behind him, and I've taken him out, and now the last wave has spawned. But I'm a decent distance from them, as you can see. And of course, I'm going to focus on these super fast elite condors, which are interceptors. This guy is flying around me almost like a wasp would, and he has gone down. And then I'm going to focus on all of the smaller ships to begin with, and then I'm just trying to get back into range again. And then I'm going to align towards this celestial. I want to be aligned towards this celestial as much as possible. The key here is I have quite good range with my missiles, and I want to attack at my maximum range whilst keeping them at arm's length. To check my range now, there we go, we've got 28 kilometer range. So if I'm holding them at that range, the people at the back of the mob, all the battle cruisers, aren't able to apply as much damage as the frigs and the cruisers up front. You, on this particular wave, providing you're not trying to Leroy into the middle of the whole swarm of ships, you should do okay, but certainly aligning to a celestial is a safe way to go about this. This mission, surprisingly, it's harder than for patriotism, yet there are no warp disruptors, so actually the risk elements are far lower, as you're not prevented from warping out, and you can always use the align out trick if need be. So I'm applying some damage now to this elite Ferox from range, trying to get him down. My cap is quite low and my shield is starting to go down. Again, I'm traveling away. I'm not within Nosferatu range, so I'm losing capacitor steadily as I'm having to tank whilst keep my other modules running. So I may have to warp out in moments, depending how this goes. I'm just gonna take out this Condor, as he will have a web, and then focus back onto this Elite Ferox. If I can get this Elite Ferox down and then warp out, it should be just another straight second run to take down the rest of this wave. So let's see if I can get him down before I need to warp. Okay, another hit or two. Yeah, he's down, so I'm gonna try and warp out now without going into hull. There are some stations here, so my plan is to warp to this belt at 100 kilometers so that I'm not landing on top of anybody that might potentially tackle me, as that was my aligned space. And then I'm warping to a station to dock. And on undocking, I would have replenished my capacitor, which you can see now is nice and full. So let's head back into Mega Corporation, and we're going to go in at a distance due to the size of this wave. Okay, we have landed, and there are quite a few ships here, so I'm just trying to work out which is going to be the best side to approach from. I'm going to go over this side, travel over here, get within range, and start applying some more damage. Again, the key is not to fly into the center of the mob. You can see that they're all in a long row. They were following me in a particular direction, so if I head to the top of this line, they are going to be spread out behind each other and not all within range. Try to avoid taking fire from as many as you can whilst taking ships out. That's the safest way to run a story mission. Okay, so applying some damage, taking out some of these cruisers pretty quickly. Seem to be tanking okay for the moment. These battle cruisers have got a lot of effective hit points, and they do take a while to chew through, unfortunately. But the Nagas in particular. At tech level 8, they're going to be quite interesting ships to fly, as you'll be using battleship sized weapons and able to run story missions like this, but shoot at incredible distances. I'm quite intrigued to see how that's going to play out. Okay, so I'm kiting the Elite Naga that you can see here now. The special thing to mention on this mission is that the regular Pith Nagas are not able to apply damage effectively if you're using an afterburner and you're traveling at, say, 600 or 700 meters per second. Very, very minimal damage. So when you find you've got 5 or 6 normal Pith Nagas and then perhaps a few Drakes and a few cruisers, you're better off leaving the Nagas until the end, as they will not be able to apply DPS very effectively, which is very similar to some of the other storyline missions which have these battle cruisers which use battleship sized weapons. Okay, so down to the last guy here now. Just going to whittle him down. I did fast forward a bit there, as you know, to try and chew through 5 battle cruisers would take a while. And we've completed the story mission. I say completed, we've completed this particular part. I would have traveled to the next set part of the mission, but of course I want to loot all these elite wrecks, so we're showing you the elite wrecks now. See if we can get anything good. We've got some Gallows large rapid launchers, again pretty good for tier 8, worth hanging on to. Some more Gallows large rapids. And we're going to get to this, I think this second to last wreck. Quite a lot of elite wrecks that you can find on these story missions, and sometimes you can be very, very lucky and get some items which are worth a good amount of ISK. Okay, so we've got a couple of challengers there. Again, they're not worth much these days. Oh, hopefully we're going to get something. Oh, and an Outlaw large shield booster. They are very expensive at the moment. That's about 40 million ISK right there, so I'm very happy with that. We've completed the previous parts of this storyline mission, so I'm now headed to the last part, which is to scan this next system I'm about to jump into. Once I've scanned this system, I will communicate with the mission NPC and complete the mission. So as you can see, I've only got these two parts left to do. So we're jumping in. Very long jump sequence this. Must be having a little bit of lag. It is a busier system indeed. Okay, so I've arrived in the system. I should get a pop-up. Yep, there we go. So scan system, let this cycle run. Okay. If I close this, it should bring up the next part of the chat, talk to this NPC, and then complete the mission, and I have been paid out for it. So that didn't take too long using my ship. I'm now going to head to, or try and see where the loot container is, the chest. Normally, for these type of ones, they're at Jita. So if I scroll down to the bottom of all my junk at Jita, there it is, the soldier supply chest. So I'm going to set destination to Jita, make my way over there, and let's show you what we get. Okay, so we've got the supply chest here. I'm going to open it up. Got two things. If I click on the first one, we've got a pretty rubbish shield field module, and then a Hook missile guidance computer. So made about 60 million ISK from the elite drops and the final chest, plus maybe 4 or 5 million ISK from the bounties, and the 30 million ISK reward. So thanks for watching.